Hi everyone, my name is Akshay and you're watching Tech Finders. So today I'm going to show you 5 best reasons why you should not purchase Redmi Y1. So here comes the 5 reasons. Wait a second, I'm going to tell you haters that I would recommend you to watch this video peacefully, and as a humble request, just give a shot to this video and then you are free to comment in the comment section below. So I'm going to display 5 best reasons why you should not purchase this device. I want you to listen just carefully these things and then you can decide by yourself whether I am correct or not before commenting in the video. So without further delaying, let's get started in this video. So here comes the first thing. The first thing is that body design. So it's not a metal design, it's having a plastic body, and also we are having a Gorilla Glass, that is 2.5D curved glass. The problem with 2.5D Gorilla Glass is that it's very fragile and you cannot paste any tempered glass or a screen protector on this because it makes it difficult to attach your screen or tempered in this phone. So now moving on to the next thing is the camera quality. The camera quality of the front camera is pretty good because it's having a 16 megapixel sensor, but when we're talking about the back camera, it's not good for low lighting. Apart from that, it's having a single tone LED at the back, although it's having a front LED flashlight so that you can use night selfies, but it not be quite useful because it's not having a lot of illumination. Apart from that, the brightness is also very less in this case. It's just a show off your product that we are having a front LED flashlight, while it's not very useful in the real scenario. And at the back, you are having a single tone LED flashlight, which will not be quite useful in low light photography. And the camera quality is 30 megapixel sensor, but it cannot be compared with Redmi Note 4. The camera quality of Redmi Note 4 is far greater than this phone. So here comes the third thing. So this phone is still having 720p resolution, which is quite outdated in 2017, I can say that. The phones are coming with 2K even 4K display, and at that time it is having a 720p display, which is quite disappointing. I would highly recommend it would have been a 1080p at least. So it's a quite disappointing when we are purchasing this phone in 2017. This phone is not a future proof. It will show the resolution issue and the pixelation as soon as you play a heavy game or you watch high definition videos in this phone. So this is the third thing which I didn't like in this phone. So here comes the fourth point, which is not pretty much appreciated in this phone. Nowadays phones are coming with USB-C type charging and with turbo boost charging. In this case, still we are having a micro USB slot in this phone. Although it is having a fast charging system, then also having micro USB as an input cable will slow your charging capacity. So it's gonna take about 2.5 hours to charge this phone. So this is what I dislike. I would have highly recommended that it should have a USB-C type of cable to make it a future-proof. Now here comes the fifth point which I dislike in this phone. The fifth point is that it's having a 3080 mAh battery, which is highly disappointed at this type of time. So it's not gonna last for even a day. If you are purchasing this phone to last for a day or longer, then this phone is not for you. It's highly recommended that you go for some other phones which are having more battery capacity than this phone. Still, Redmi 4 is better choice than this phone, although it has some drawbacks, but which can be overpowered when we are considering in terms of battery, in terms of performance. So here comes the pro tip for all the users. It is having an octa-core processor, which is very good. The drawback is that it is having 1.4 GHz clock speed only, and all the 8 cores are A53 and there is no A72 chip included. For people those who don't know more about this processor, I want to tell him that A53 and A72 are 2 core processor of this chipset, and A53 is used for basic performance and A72 is used for higher performance. So if you are playing a lot of games, then A72 will function as it is having more higher clock speed. It is better than A53. So all the 8 cores in this case are A53 only. So if you are playing high games or watching high definition videos, then this phone is pretty much gonna disappoint you in this case. So these are the 5 things which I didn't like in this phone, and now you are free to comment your opinions in the comment section below, and also there will be a video of 5 reasons why you should purchase this phone. So I'm gonna do a video on that too also. So thank you for watching. This is Akshay signing off, and catch you in the next video.